This has to be the most common issue that I face both with my clients and anybody else that tries tracking their calories, and whether the goal is to lose weight, gain weight, they just can't seem to get the scale to budge. And so they begin to think that calorie tracking isn't the way to go. This method doesn't work for them, etc. And I can tell you right now, okay, do not switch off this video, because it is a guarantee that if you track calories and you eat a certain amount, that you will move the needle. You will move the needle on the scale and in your results. However, there are some different factors I've found over the years of answering this question that can pertain to different scenarios, different individuals, and so on. And so I'm gonna make this ultimate video to break down the only reasons why you may not be seeing the results you want, even though you're tracking your calories. So let's go. What's good, YouTube? It's Coach John back again, repping Beyond the Iron. I'm dropping weekly fitness content on this channel to help you with your goals. So if you're interested in getting to them faster and in a more enjoyable way, hit the subscribe button below. Also, just a heads up, at the end of this video, I will share with you a free resource that you can get, but I definitely encourage you to stay, watch until the end, because every single point of this is very important to take note of. And there are definitely things that a lot of people seem to oversee or underestimate or just miss altogether. And the most important reason why you're tracking calories and are not seeing the scale move is going to come at the end, as saving the best for last. So I want to reiterate this before we jump in with the first point here, okay? This system is a guarantee. As a matter of fact, it's not a system. I hate to label it that way. It is literally the only path to either losing weight or gaining weight. You must know how many calories you're burning, and if you want to gain weight, you have to eat over that. If you want to lose weight, you have to eat under it. So if you seem to be tracking your calories and the weight is not moving, that is a very good indication that either you're not eating as much as you think, or there's some other discrepancies that we'll cover today that may be the reason why the scale isn't showing the results that you think you should be seeing. Okay, the first thing, we got to get this one out of the way, and this is something that's often overlooked, but the scale, okay? The actual scale itself may not be reliable. Now, you may have a good reliable scale, but maybe you have it on an uneven surface. I've had clients that had it on carpet and wondered why the fluctuations are so big. So the scale is very important. Make sure that it's an accurate scale. How do you know? Well, make sure it's on a flat, even surface, and step off and get three weigh-ins. Step off, step back on. Do it three times in three different spots. And if the weigh-ins are widely different, or you don't get a single weigh-in close to one another, chances are you might want to get a new scale. If you want some scale recommendations, I have two videos on two top scales that I recommend that are going to get you the reliability and the accuracy that you need. You can check those out up here. Now, the second thing is your weigh-in protocol. This is also something widely overlooked, okay? Weigh-in protocol, what I mean by this is, when and how do you take your weigh-ins? So, for example, you might have a weigh-in first thing in the morning one day, and then the next day you weigh in at the gym because you forgot to in the morning. The following day, you weigh in before the gym because you remembered, and so on. I think you get the picture. The point is it's very inconsistent. Now, the scale is not the be-all, end-all of tools and resources to depend and rely on. However, it's still a very powerful resource if you use it correctly. And the best way to get the most accurate reading, most consistently, is by getting a solid weigh-in protocol. And in this case, the best weigh-in protocol to do that would be to step on the scale first thing in the morning before you eat or drink anything, because even drinking a liter of water or a glass of water can fluctuate that number, and after you use the restroom so that you deplete your body of any excess water that you may be holding onto from the prior night. So that's the weigh-in protocol. Now, you might be thinking, well, what if I miss a weigh-in? My recommendation is always, if you miss the weigh-in, do not get the weigh-in for that day. If you miss it in the morning, guess what? Skip that day, but make sure you get the next mornings, because then people start going to the gym, they get this. And trust me, weighing in at night, you can try it out yourself. You can test it every single night. Weigh yourself from the morning time to the night time. You're almost always going to be up higher at night because you've eaten tons of food, you've drank lots of water, hopefully. And so that's why you want a consistent, accurate, and proper weigh-in protocol. well. So that's the second thing. Now, the third thing could be meal timing. Now, I've made videos in the past as to why meal timing isn't something that you should be too focused on. However, just know that there's a possibility that it's skewing the number on the scale, in the sense that if you have a very big meal late at night before you go to bed and you're waking up not that long after, right? The chances are that it could skew that way, and it could show up as if you've weighed in heavier, but in reality, it's just that your body hasn't processed all the food, it hasn't had enough time to digest, and it hasn't metabolized a lot of it yet. So because of that, it could show up on the scale, and this is actually why that common myth of don't eat carbs before bed came about, is because if you have a lot of carbs right before bed, typically it shows up on the scale. People made the mistake of course, thinking that a couple numbers up on the scale means you just gained 2 pounds of fat, which is complete bullshit, as we hopefully know if you've been watching my channel long enough. And so for that reason, just make sure that if you do have those meals at night, that that is one of the factors that you consider if you feel like you don't see what you feel like you should be seeing on the scale. So if that scale jumps up one day, even though you stayed on your calories, that's always something you got to keep in mind. Did you eat a late, big, carb-heavy meal last night? If so, that's fine. It's going to iron out over the week's weigh-ins. And also, if you do it every single night, that's totally fine as well. Your baseline weigh-ins are just going to be a little higher, but you're going to see the same trend of progress over time, okay? So keep in mind, if you had a late meal last night, that could be why the scale is heavier than you expected it to be. My recommendation for that, of course, is to try to be more consistent with those meals. And I find, again, for the sake of max accuracy in the morning and in dry weight on the scale, I like to stop eating my food a couple hours before bed at least. Next is sodium, water, and carbohydrate inconsistencies, okay? I grouped all these together because they all have very similar traits in the fact that they can actually skew the scale quite a bit because they can cause your body to retain water, okay? Carbs, if you eat a lot of carbs, even though you stay into your calories, carbs will store as glycogen in the muscles and the liver, and glycogen pulls water in with it, okay? Now, this isn't fat. Again, it might show up on the scale like you gained a few pounds, but it's actually lean body mass. So I wouldn't freak out about that. If you're staying within your calories over time, consistently, again, you don't want to just look at it day to day, but week to week, month to month, etc., you're going to be fine. Same thing with sodium. If you had a lot more sodium than you usually do yesterday, again, that's going to retain more water and it could show up on the scale. And lastly, inconsistency with water. For example, me, I'm used to drinking 5 to 6 liters of water a day. One day, if I'm not drinking nearly as much, maybe I only have 1 to 2 liters, because whatever happens, I guess the world's coming to an end if that happens to John Mango, right? Let's say that happens, I'm gonna show up a lot lighter on the scale, and that could be deceptive as well. And on the other side, if you drink a lot more water than you usually do because you're starting to get into the habit of doing so, then understand it's probably gonna show up on the scale for a day or two. Obviously, the best way to combat this is keep it all consistent. Again, if you need to, build the habit of drinking more water, but once you get to that point, make sure you're consistent with it and that it's not up and down day to day, because that's gonna throw your scale readings way off. The next thing, the fifth thing, is activity levels. So something a lot of people overlook or miss altogether is the fact that in different days, you have different amounts of energy being expended. So I'll give you an example in terms of the gym. When I do a leg day, legs are massive muscle groups. The leg workouts take 2 hours instead of an hour and a half, and I am destroyed by the end of them. For the rest of the day, I'm extremely hungry and tired, okay? That's because a massive amount of calories have been burned throughout that leg workout, as opposed to an arm workout or a chest workout or just a core and cardio day. That entire day, I'm not burning nearly as many calories when it comes to the gym. On the other hand, it can be in discrepancies as simple as you took the stairs that day the whole time, or you went and moved like I did recently into this condo. Moving day, you're burning an insane amount of calories, and so that could fluctuate the scale big time. If you're trying to gain weight and you're not seeing that weight gain, ask yourself, how are your activity levels? If the weight isn't moving when you're trying to come down, look at your NEAT, non-exercise activity thermogenesis, and see, are you moving a lot less throughout the day? Are you only going for one walk instead of two? All these different things. So that is a very important thing. And again, try to, if you can't keep them consistent, at least try to monitor it and understand when you need to adjust. For example, if it's a rest day, you might want to adjust your calories down on that rest day if it's a lot less expenditure than on the days that you're working out or on another day, etc. So I would at least monitor these and see how your body reacts to potentially adjusting the calories on those days. All right, so we've come to the last point, number six, and this is the most important one, and this is the cause of 99% of why people track their calories but don't see the results. Because again, this is a guarantee. And so here it is. Are you ready for this? I'll show you. It has to do with this right here. You are not tracking as accurately as you think, okay? And now you might be thinking, John, what are you talking about? You call me a liar, man? Honestly, yeah, a little bit, but not an intentional liar, okay? Simply this, what you have to understand is when we're eating day to day and maybe tracking calories is a new habit for you, okay? If that's the case, this is almost a 100% guarantee that this is the reason why you're messing up. Amongst others, it could be a combination of things, but in this case, let's say this. Ask yourself, did you really weigh the sauce that you put on the salad? Did you weigh out those cashews or did you just take the handful and go? Did you weigh out the chewy bars that you thought a couple hundred calories wouldn't skew the results? You know, did you count the sugar and milk that you put in the coffee in the morning? All of these things are things that I always say slip through the cracks and people are unaware of. Now, how do I know that this is the case? Well, typically if I see a large male, at least over 200 pounds, eating 1200 calories and the scale's staying the same or increasing, what do I know right now? I know for a 100% fact, guaranteed, that that man is not eating what he thinks he's eating, or he's at least not tracking everything he's eating, okay? Because a lot of times we go throughout the day and we don't think to track something, or we think that just because we're inputting things into MyFitnessPal that all of a sudden we're doing everything we should be doing to see results, or I'm working harder than I was before so I should see results. It's not the case. This is not a forgiving system, a forgiving method, okay? Calories in versus calories out is a law. You can't be flexible and bend it a little bit. It's either in or out. It's either you lose weight or you don't. You ate too much or you didn't. You tracked it right or you didn't. So you have to really be honest with yourself. Take a step back and I want you to analyze, almost like corporate raiding a business. I want you to corporate raid your nutrition. Walk every single thing you eat throughout a day. Analyze and see, oh, because I've done this myself and I'm doing this for the better part of a decade. I even analyze sometimes and I say, I missed tracking this, or I forgot to weigh the walnuts. Okay, that's hundreds of calories that you're likely letting slip through the cracks and thinking, but I'm tracking, you know? Come on, do I really have to weigh in? Do I really have to do this extra stuff? I'm tracking. No, I don't care. The people that track just by putting a few things in MyFitnessPal but don't see results are the ones that give this whole tracking calories thing a bad rap. They're the ones that created keto. They're the ones that are feeding those, all these other programs and cookie cutter systems that will never lead you to the results you want, like tracking calories will. So stop making excuses, figure out what it is that you're missing out on, and stop lying to yourself, okay? Be honest with yourself. A man over 200 pounds eating 1200 calories, not losing weight, it's bullshit, I'll tell you right now. And a woman eating 800 calories, not losing weight, that's over 200 pounds, same thing, it's bullshit. And you know it. So those are the six reasons, the six things, the six factors that are likely either one or multiple of them are responsible for why you're not seeing the results, even though you feel like you should be because you're tracking your calories. Again, listen, this is a guarantee. If you're not losing weight, it has nothing to do with your metabolism, your age, or this, or that. It has to do with the factors that I just mentioned, okay? And if you're missing out on them, it's not the system, it's you. So fix what you're doing and you will see results better than you ever could on any other program out there. And so with that said, I hope that you found this video helpful. I know it was a little bit longer and I really wanted to get this point across, make sure that I covered everything in this video. And if you have any other thoughts, comments, topics you want to see or anything, let me know also what you thought about this video in the comments below. I know I'm going to be sending this one to all of my clients in the future. And so with that said, thanks so much for watching. Again, like, comment, share, subscribe, so you see every other video I drop every other week. So with that said, oh, and one last thing, I almost forgot to tell you, the free resource, you can click the link down below. I put together a short, brief, one-page summary of the factors that I spoke about here that you can always print off, keep beside you, or keep somewhere to remind you why you may not be seeing those results. I think it'd be very beneficial for you, and I hope that you enjoy that. So you can click that in the link below and get it for free. Okay, so that's it, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Thanks again for watching, and I'm out.